my argument with Cassavetes and Nico Papatakis had to do with shadows. When Nico Papatakis made a film already with Genet, that was Chant d'Amour. And he had some cabaret in Paris. That's where this young woman, I don't know what her real, I never saw the biography of Nico or read any books. I still have not seen the film. Came in and he liked her and her singing, and she adopted the name of Nico from Nico Papatakis. And later when they came to New York, since I had met them already in Paris before, they wanted to meet Andy. I took them to Andy, and that's where, you know, life, different life of Nico begins. He was at the screening of Shadows, and he thought, being sort of more commercially minded, that it was to lose to, that this film could be made into commercial success if he would only reshoot like about one third of it. Take some scenes out and add new ones and skip the beginning, cut and 3 minutes there. And Cassavetes agreed with him. Now, why? Okay, I will sort of jump, but it's like a collage, what I'm saying here now, is he reshot, and I was there through much of the reshooting. Then when I saw the new version, they were so different. One was when somebody sees the one that exists now, and that's the second version, and has not seen the first version, still the film is very good, and everybody likes it, and it's still very important. And different in style and more loose, but you cannot compare with the first version, which was totally completely improvised. It's like jazz, very. In any case, it was reshot. And I had written very enthusiastic review of the first one. And now I see the second version. I had to really put it down, and that's where, you know, our argument began. Of course, we were not on talking terms then with Cassavetes for 10 years or so. Later, we made peace. But it was like a very different film, and that's where Nico, and I blame Nico Papatakis for it. Now, to add something to it, why Cassavetes did that? I think only lately I came to this conclusion, what I'm saying, will be saying now. And that is that he never wanted to make a film like the first version was. That was done by the sort of actors and friends that he worked in and permitted them to do. And he had yet no power. He had not made no film. He had been already in films. And when he went to really his own film and had money to make his own film where he had complete control to do the way he wanted, he ended up in what he was really later doing, which is, again, very, I think, important and very unique and very strong. His place in American cinema is very, very important. He went for sort of controlled improvisation, like permitted them, which the only other filmmaker that I could compare what he was doing with what Paul Morrissey was doing in the three, not in the Warhol film, but in his three films, Flesh, whatever, it is one four-letter title, his trilogy, where he permitted them, his performers, his people, some were actors, some non-actors, same in Cassavetes. You give certain idea and you work just within that, and then if you can jump out of it, and if it works, you will include, if not, not. And that's what Cassavetes sort of developed and amazingly where actors were permitted then within that very loose framework to open themselves with no control practically, and the content becomes sort of very emotional and rich, and the conflicts which no other Hollywood director, if one can call Cassavetes Hollywood, ever did, and Hollywood never embraced. He never had commercial success. He's having now, like, not a commercial success, but in all of the film club societies, etc., etc. So, in other words, what I was defending and why I attacked Cassavetes, I was defending, really, when I look at the first version, what I myself wanted to do. So I was, in that sense, wrong, what I did. I did not understand enough myself, and I did not understand enough him. And I sort of thought that that was his film, and he should not have changed. But really, it was more my film, and therefore I defended it. You should have left it as is.